Hello, welcome back to the draw stream. Let's keep on drawing Harry and Heather. I'm thinking of maybe like redoing his face so that it looks more one-to-one exactly what Harry looks like on the PS1. But we'll approach that later. No biggie. Oh my god, can I get my headphone jack to be comfortable here? Oops. Yeah, I was sick yesterday. I got sick again. But it was for the people, I mean, I just said this, but for the people who's watching on YouTube and the people that just came in, I was playing the Turing test for like 40 minutes or so, and I was fine. And then within a span of like 5 minutes, I got so nauseous out of nowhere. I have never been affected by any game before in that way, like becoming motion sick like that. So that is pretty strange for me. Even games that are like known for doing that to people, they usually do not affect me that way, so that kind of threw me for a loop. I thought I was getting like actually sick. And I had to quit the stream after only like 45 minutes, which sucked. I hated to do that, but I was like, I could not even like move the mouse without like feeling like I wanted to puke all of a sudden. It was rough. It was really weird. But I'm okay now, yeah, don't worry about me. This is the wrong brush, isn't it? Also, do I have... No, it's not doing the thing! There, now it's doing the thing. I tried to fix this the other day, and it was me clicking that thing up there did not actually fix it before, so I don't know what's up with that. Well, anyway, that's the wrong doodle bob anyway, I think. Yeah, it should not have transfer on it. Yeah, people mentioned Doom's head bobbing gave people motion sickness. I never played the original Doom, but I don't know. I played like all of Half-Life 2 perfectly fine, and I heard Half-Life 2 was also one of those kinds of games where people just get sick really easily. So I just thought that will never be me. Then I met the Turing test and it kicked my ass. Completely whooped me and made me so nauseous. So yeah, I just laid down for like a whole hour, and then I was mostly better. I was still off for like 3 hours after, at least 3 hours after that. Sucked. Kind of took like a mini nap. That might have also kind of fucked up my shit, because I'm fucking terrible at taking naps, so that might have made me just feel a little bit worse, actually. I don't know. It's hard to tell. Well, when you're nauseous, you don't want to be awake at all. You don't want to even exist. So, I took my chances. Although, I do remember when I was little... Oh my god, what grade was I in? I must have been in, like, third, maybe second grade. There was some... educational video game for the PC. I don't even know if it was really like a quote-unquote game. I don't know if there was like any gameplay in it or anything, but it was something to do with like a hospital and like surgery, and it was all like that crappy early CG from the 90s that looked really bad and had like a frame rate of 12 or so. And I remember playing that for a while, and that made me really, really sick feeling. It was like first person walking around a hospital, and then like when you went to certain places, it would be like, this is how heart surgery is done, without any like gore or anything like that. I have no clue what this game is though. If you know that game, that'll be like a really weird blast from the past for me. I haven't thought of this game in like decades. Like, me and my cousins rented that for some reason because we didn't know what good video games were, and we're just like, surgery? What? Do you get to do the surgery? I think you don't. I don't think you do the surgery. You just walk around a hospital and learn about hospital stuff. But just walking around the hospital was like so fucking nauseating. Rib spreader. I don't know if this actually had surgery in it. That'd be pretty cool if it did. I think it was purely educational, but I'm not certain. Oh, they might have played on Giant Bomb once? Oh, Am I sure the transfer is not on still? Because that seems like transfer. Told you not to be on. Get off of here, you varmint. You're still on. What are you doing? Get off of there. I said no transfer, you piece of shit. What's wrong with you? Transfer off. Are you actually off? No. What are you doing? What if I turn this doodle off? Okay, it was that thing. What is that thing? When I hover over it, doesn't say anything. Always use pressure for opacity. No. That's what transfer is for. Don't troll me, Photoshop. Making it harder to do the drawings here. This is way better. Black lines, please. Thanks. So what was the name of that hospital game that you thought might have been that one? So I'd be interested in checking it out and seeing if that is indeed the one. Digging this curve here. Bangs. Anyway, how is everybody? Hope y'all had a good weekend. Mine was fine. Had some friends over and we played Tales of the Arabian Nights, the board game. Which is a really fun, weird board game that has basically no strategy in it. I have no idea how you can play the game with a strategy in mind. It's just so random. Kind of playing the game and seeing what happens sort of game. Her hair doesn't look right. I fucked it up. What's wrong with her fucking hair? It's not looking like Heather's hair. What's a weekend? What's a board game? Grossology? No, I don't think it was that. That does look familiar though. I think like some computer class had that. She's got emo hair going on here. Nah, it was not that. No. It was not cartoony at all. It was like a real looking hospital for God knows why. It was like a purely educational game. Like, it was not edutainment. Like, it was, I think it was just education. This does not look like her hair. I need a picture reference of Heather for no reason. Why are these incognito tabs? I don't want incognito tabs. Oh, weird. Oops, I keep hitting my tablet with my arm. Oh, this is why her hair is going all the wrong direction. Boy. Yes, I am drawing your request. Hello, Minus Needles. How are you? Heather, you're huge, Heather. Just want to see what your hair looks like, girl. Longing for the moon. Yeah, I was getting her hair all sorts of stupid and wrong. Nope. I'm also injecting a personality into Heather. She doesn't really have too much fun. She had more than most female characters did in the year 2003, though. I gotta give her credit where credit's due. Some funky ass saxophone in here.
Emergency game from 3D Body Adventure?
I don't know. Maybe. I don't remember. Maybe it wasn't FMV. I don't know. Man, this is quite a mystery going on here all of a sudden. Hey, indestructible cat. What up? This is like spy music. Oh, the game has first person mode? Yo, that might be it, actually. Emergency game from 3D Body Adventure. Huh. That very well may be the thing. That's crazy. I think that might be it. Oh, what's Heather wearing in that photo? It's one of the unlockable costumes that you can get in Silent Hill 3. Silent Hill 3 has a lot of unlockable costumes. Some of them are pretty goofy. Douglas can just wear just his underwear, look like a weird streaker. pretty funny. Yeah, Heather has a lot of unlockable costumes. There's even more in the PS2 version than there is in the PC version, because the PS2 version has a bunch of unlockables for individual gaming magazines from around the world, so it'll be her wearing, like, you know, a GameSpot shirt or something like that. Yeah, unlockable in that you type a password. Some of them are unlockable, but all of them do work in that you, if you just look on GameFAQs, you can put a code just, you know, that you find on GameFAQs into the game. But to get the code, you originally had to, you know, do something. Or buy a magazine. The magazines just had the code for that specific magazine's outfit in there. Get this one little piece of hair right. Ah! Yeah, they even had like Spanish gaming magazines and stuff like that represented in that unlockable costume demographic. Needs to be a little fluffier on this end. Yeah, he wears his underwear underneath his big detective coat. He looks like a fucking goofy weirdo. Pretty funny though. Dress for the job you want. So he wanted to be one of those like novelty bachelorette party strippers. Hello, I'm a detective. I'm here to investigate an extremely sexy lady who's getting married soon. Man, I'm just having a bad hair day right now. Yeah, she is kind of atypical for a horror story. And also she's pretty, like, rare for, like, a Japanese-developed game, too. I feel like, you know, a lot of female protagonists. Like, I'm also speaking from the perspective of the early 2000s. It's been a lot better since. But Japan was not known at the time, and especially in horror games, for making super capable, you know, ladies. Like, there was Resident Evil, that was about it. You know, I don't know. A lot of ladies in a lot of horror games are just there to, like, scream and get eaten by monsters or something. Heather's hair's a little difficult because it's, like, messy. So it's hard to, like, not make it too busy. Checking out a lot of cool women, but were they all, like, bodaciously half-naked? I don't know a shitload about Tekken, but I'm, you know, fighting games in general are pretty well known for having kind of grody lady designs. Sorry. weird too. Everything looks weird. I'm gonna have to check that game out later. I'm gonna write a personal note, actually. What was that called? Like, 3D emergency room or something? Very nostalgically interested in that. Played it for a day, but it left an impression because it made me so nauseous to play it. Emergency game from 3D Body Adventure. Okay, emergency game 3D Body Adventure. What a ridiculous name. That might be it. That very well might be it. Can't play the video in case there's copyright music in it, and then it'll fuck up my stream. I'll just have to check it out later. Thanks for the tip, the info. I'll give her her roots later. She's got like black roots. Oh, she's neat. Spending way too much time on her hair because it's giving me trouble today. Move on. Do some other shit. Yeah, I don't know a ton about, like, really any fighting games. I just, like, have basic general knowledge that they exist. I have no interest in fighting games. They all kind of blend together for me. I'm used to more than half of them having like really weird character designs in general, but like the ladies are just like, you know, jiggling masses for the most part. And I'm just bad at them too, you know. If you don't have interest in them, you're gonna be shitty at them. Oh shit, that cover art is radical. It looks mildly familiar, but it might just be because it looks very The Cher Zone. Yeah, I wonder if that's the game that I accidentally rented and it made me sick. That is a fucking radical skeleton, holy shit. Music's fun. Gotta remember to give her freckles later. Not a great character design. That's kind of like what I expect of fighting games female characters. I expect them to be pretty bodaciously dressed. Not a sensibly dressed. Even like the guys are not sensibly dressed in those games. Like fucking Voldo. What the fuck is with Voldo? That guy's weird. It's not a sensible fighting outfit at all. There's tons of belts and nipple clamps and chains and... It's like the only fighting game character I know though, so I guess it's a memorable character design. I guess it works out. Smuggler. My goodness. Well, it's a great character design because then he's like really evasive and he's hard to find if he's in a, you know, if he's on a beach with a lot of umbrellas that are also red and white, and or at a bazaar that also has a lot of tents that are red and white striped. There have been Where's Waldo games, and they're all, like, really stupid. Like, find the pixel games. Fun! I always wondered why... Well, I guess I never really always wondered it, but I have wondered in the past. It's not something that haunts me or anything. I have wondered in the past why... Does Waldo have a walking cane? I know, like, he walks a lot and he travels a lot, which, you know, good for him, but, like, that's not, like, a hiking cane. That's just, like, an old person's cane. Oh my god. What the fuck is that character design? He looks like a cyber tingle. Cyber Tingle Tuppy, yeah. It's a bit of a... It's like they had a dartboard that had all sorts of weird shit on it, and they just threw darts, and they're like, alright, design that. I don't care. Just get it done. Get on my desk Monday. I don't care how stupid it is, get it on my desk Monday. Oh, it's a magical stick? Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. Yo, what is this Waldo lore? There's Waldo lore? A wizard? What? Oh my god. What the fucking hell? Also, I know, like, Waldo is also- he's Wally in other countries or something. I don't know why. Maybe it wouldn't have sold well if it was Wally in America, I don't know. I don't think we're that racist against the Brits, I don't know, Wallys. Deep Waldo lore. I know there's different characters. I know there's a dog. I don't know the dog's name. There's a lady version of Waldo. I think it's like his sister. I don't think it's his girlfriend. I think it's his sister or something like that. Oh yeah, well that's a query as old as time. The what's up with the Disney dogs query. It's a little weird. No, it's not Carmen Sandiego. I mean, it was a lady version of Waldo slash Wally. Definitely a different character and a different intellectual property than Carmen Sandiego, who was never a, you know, find in big confusing picture character. She was edutainment based geography learning, not just like, hey, try to find this thing in a big confusing piece of big confusing illustration. Blech. There was a Waldo cartoon. Yeah, I never saw it, but I knew of its existence for some reason. Trolls too. That does look like the nerdy guy in Troll 2 that says, "Oh my god!" and then gets turned into a plant and eaten. He does look like Waldo a little bit. Yeah, there's the lady and the dog. Yeah. Yeah. I have no idea what their names are. I bet her name is Wendy or something. It's gotta start with a W. Definitely gotta start with a W. Tijan. There's two girl Waldos? Shut up, really? You could just be making shit up and I'd be like, wow, cool. Waldo lore. I would never know. I wouldn't look it up later. You'd be like, hey, there's a Waldo cat too, and I'll be like, yeah, okay, sure. You're probably right. Wally, Woof, and Wenda. Okay, yeah. Wenda. Ugh. Wenda's not a great name. There's a Waldo wiki. There's a wiki for everything now. Everything. Can't escape all these wikis. I wonder what the Silent Hill wiki's doing. There's really like not much to fucking add to it anymore, so wonder if there's still lore building happening that is not really based in reality. By reality I mean canon, the games. Not really reality. Wilma, ew. Wenda and Wilma, ew. I hate those names. They're bad. This isn't especially groovy. Sounds like the credits to like a 90s video game. Yeesh, Wilma. Very strange looking. Where is Wilma? Oof, have you seen her? She's a missing person. Do you think there's like Waldo enthusiasts that collect a lot of Waldo merchandise? Like how there's like Garfield enthusiasts that collect all the Garfield shit? I'll probably get rid of Heather there. Goodbye, Heather. Well, I guess I could keep her around for the hair reference, like the colors, I mean. You got the touch. Yeah, it's like one of those songs. You got the power. Yeah. Oh yes, I remember the bad guy. The bad guy's name was Oddlaw, because it was Waldo backwards. Do you get it? Indestructible Cat's still trying to think of cool ladies in games that are Japanese games. It's not like, I mean, from the early 2000s, specifically. I don't recall very many, which is why Heather was kind of like a big-ish deal. Not like a big deal, but rare, is what I mean. It was interesting. Ayabrea? I heard she wasn't bad, and then third birthday happened, and then she was bad. That's all I know about Ayabrea. I had some sort of demo disc on the PS1, and it was radical, because like it had Spyro 1 on it, it had maybe one of the Crash Bandicoots on it, it had like the first level of like one of the Tony Hawks on there, and it had a trailer for Parasite Eve, and I thought the trailer looked like so fucking radical. And the voiceover for it was really good, because there was like this guy who was like, millions of years ago, the mitochondria began to live silently within our bodies. And I thought that guy was fucking hilarious. And that's not how you say mitochondria, so I thought this was great. And I never actually got to play the game though, because it looked too scary. There was no actual demo of that game on that demo disc, it was just a trailer. I probably wouldn't have liked it if I played it though. Whoa, this sounds like the beginning of Journey's Worlds Apart. Oh my god. Here we stand. Worlds apart, hearts broken in two. This band knew what they were doing when they stole this song. They have the rat. You get to see the rat like turn inside out in the demo reel thing. That was neat. Chip was playing Parasite Eve recently. Not recently, I mean, I guess it was a couple months ago, actually. But he wanted to show me it, and I was like, oh shit, I remember this rat getting turned inside out. And I have, like, no idea what the plot actually is, but it was pretty fucking hilarious to actually, like, see what the game is like, and the fucking... It starts at like an opera and like she's on a date and like everyone bursts into flames and fucking dies. And that was like her first date with some guy. Everyone bursting into flames and dying. He turned out okay. I think somebody who was on fire may have landed on him though and injured him. It was pretty weird. Does Bayonetta count? She's not early 2000s enough, is she? When did Bayonetta come out? She was like 2009 or 10? When did Bayonetta come out, actually? I feel like that's too late for what I'm talking about. With, like, Silent Hill 3. Silent Hill 3 was, like, 2003. Yeah, there's Samus, but I feel like Samus is one of those weird cases where it's like she doesn't really have a personality, so it's hard for, I don't know. Like, she doesn't talk, so it's hard to inject a personality onto a person. Like, does Gordon Freeman count as a strong male character? He's just, you know, no, a nobody. Like, is he really a person? Is he really a character? Like, meh, not really. He gets to do cool stuff. People look up to him. You can kind of infer his character through people's reactions to him, but I don't know. Kind of it's a tricky situation when the protagonist doesn't talk. It's hard to be like, oh yeah, they're a strong character. It's like, do you really know that though? Because they don't talk at all. That's not to say that you can't have a strong character that is mute or doesn't talk. Like fucking, like Wally is a really good character. Yeah, Meryl. Meryl counts. Ish. Although she had her own, you know, issues and stuff. And, eh. I want to be a soldier. My father. He's not really my dad. Her skirt's too short, actually. I think it's not that short in the game. It's closer to her knees. Ever since I was a little girl, I wanted to prove myself to a man, my dad, you know, like, She's okay. Then she gets, like, immediately, like, captured and is a liability for most of the game. Olga was cool, though. I like Olga a lot, actually. When was that? Was that 2003? I think that might have been around the same time, actually. Yeah, that too, hell. Also a point to consider. Well, Olga started off preggers. She was already preggers at the beginning of MGS2. And then when she was a ninja, she already had her kid, and her kid had been stolen by the Patriots. God, get it right, Lord Smith. Get it right. So I'm zooming out when I need to zoom in. Oops. Who was the dad? I don't think anyone knows who the dad is of Olga's child. I'll have to ask Chip about that. I don't think it's actually mentioned who the dad is. Sniper Wolf was also very weirdly horny. Not a huge fan of Sniper Wolf. Then, like, all the characters in MGS5 are bad. Men and women, everyone's bad. Yeah, go rewatch Drunk Metal Gear. Who were good characters in MGS5? I'm actually trying to think. Akiba? Maybe? I don't know. Akiba was funny, at least. Yeah, there it is. Parasite Eve. Yeah! Enough, I'm thinking of four. I'm thinking of four. Sorry, my bad. Strike that. Pretend I said four, because I was thinking of four. I was thinking of Old Snake when I was talking about that. I was thinking of Naomi and how bad Naomi is in MGS4. Rose is bad in that too? God, I don't like Metal Gear Solid 4. It's not a good time. Ugh. Yeah, it's that rat. That cool rat. Oh man. That cool rat is so cool. Longing for the moon. Gotta change this just to be zoom in all the time. Okay, I wanna probably fix Harry's face, since I think it doesn't look funny enough. I think it'd be funnier if it was actually his PS1 face. Yep, that's her date, and she just like fucking shoulder checks him out the door. Oh, so cool. Mary Mason face, PS1. Oh no, it's Sean Bean. No, I don't want Sean Bean. I want a really close shot of his crappy polygon face. Oh, here's a really good gif. Shit, okay. Can I post this in the chat? No. I don't think I can. It's too big of a... Okay, what if I open it in a new tab? Oh, it's a giphy. It's a giphy. View image. Can I link this great thing? Yes, there he is. Well, she took a gun on the date because she's like a cop, man. She's tough. Gotta bring the gun with her everywhere. Not enough shots of Harry Mason's pixely ass face. A lot of gifts, though. There's a lot of really funny fan art, though. I don't know who half these fan arts are about, but they're pretty. Some of them are kind of goofy. Okay. Oh, this might be good enough. Oh, I like that one. That one's like. I see that one around a lot. I guess it's famous. Big dumb face, Harry. Okay, so he looks so weird there, doesn't he? What if I just, like, take his dumb face, just put it right there? There you go. Travis having a shitload of TVs. It's really good. There's a lot of good references in that piece of art. Should I make Harry look a little bit more stupid? Yeah, I'm trying to like imagine, like what if I just slapped it on? Looking good. Man, you can still beat it. Make a mask so that we can come back to this. Slenderman. He's a Slenderman now. So I meant to get rid of this bit here. Some groovy tunes going on here. He looks stern right now. I'll try to make him not look stern in a minute. Mm-hmm. No, Henry was part of the 21 sacraments. He was the receiver of wisdom.
Guys.
He did just, you know, rent the wrong apartment, but by renting the wrong apartment, he became part of the ceremony. Henry slash the player is the receiver of wisdom, if you want to get meta on it. Oh, you haven't played Silent Hill? Yeah, this will all be very confusing to you then. It's too difficult to get into, trust me. There's no way to sum up Silent Hill 4 in a succinct manner that makes any sort of fucking sense. It would take like 20 minutes to even like get the basics down about that fucking game. So like, Harry just looks kind of annoyed here. And he just looks kind of stoned here. So blurry, it's hard to like make out what's the bits here. That is a good summary of Silent Hill 4. Guy rents the wrong apartment. Yeah, that's pretty much it. What does that mean over there? Ludlick donated $601, is that real? I've never seen anyone donate anything, so I don't know if that's just somebody doing one of those, like, you know, those things where it's like, oh, so-and-so coughs, or whatever. I'll check it out later. If you did donate that much money, I would appropriately freak out about it, but I'm suspicious that that's not really what that means. It's a meme, right? It's just somebody typing that in, right? It's not like a real thing. Yeah, that's what I thought. That would be cool, but I didn't think it was happening, so. He's not doing the Frankenfurter phrase. There's not enough sass to it. So yeah, I don't know, what's our preferred face here? He looks kind of weird. No, he became the receiver of wisdom because, like, Joseph was tied to that apartment and was trying to tell him stuff. So basically, he still became the receiver of wisdom just because he chose that apartment. Like, whoever got that apartment would be the receiver of wisdom, I think. I think. The people's eyebrow. I think he looks better without the nostril there. I think he looks pretty good. Let's compare faces here. He's just floating. Now he looks kind of like Yara Naika. I don't know. Yeah, the bad guy is Walter Sullivan in that thingy. Or I just like shut off a mask. I don't actually know how to shut off a mask. I know how to delete a mask. Disable. Yeah, so do we like that hairy face? Or do we like the other hairy face? Just make it a little easier here. Do we like that hairy face or this hairy face? Eh? Happy? A little, you know, more accurate, but no, it's happy. I kind of like the happy face better. Yeah, the whole 21 Sacraments thing is like super whack though. He is a little more seductive looking there, that's true, and he's writing a he's reading and writing a romance novel, so. Oh. You guys tell me what you feel like there. He does look kind of smug there. He's so friendly. I like the friendly one better. Yeah, let's just go with the friendly one. Just delete this. There, yeah. And Minus Needles is the commissioner, so he would know. I want to make like the side here look more like it's from a book jacket, you know? I made that all part of the line art. That's a little silly of me. Don't do that. Doesn't like faceless Harry. Portland based. Bothering me here. That's official art. I thought you were like, wow, look at this fan art. I think that's official, that's actually concept art.
Unless there's something goofy on the screen or something. No, that's just concept art from Shattered Memories.
Actual legit concept art. Ugh, the game is fucking goofy. She's 16. pictured right. I don't know how to write these things. I don't read them very often. He's also known for... What other books has Harry written? The thing is that, like, Harry is a writer in Silent Hill 1, but I don't think it, like, clarifies a writer of what? You know? Like, he could be a journalist for all I know. But I think he's a novelist, technically. But they don't, like, ever list any books he's made. And the only book that's ever mentioned is in Shattered Memories, it's Longing for the Moon. So, make up fake stupid names. For blank, blank, and the blank series. I want a series in there. That was my elbow on the table, sorry. Whispers to the Ocean. Oh, I like that actually because it sounds like Longing for the Moon. Yeah. Jupiter is below. No, Son of Spellsinger. The Spellsinger series. Bridge Over the Sorrow. Yeah, that does sound pretty. That sounds pretty airport novel-y right there. Messages to the Rain. Tweets to the Void. Can't spell. Quiet Mountain. I don't think he would ever write about it ever again. I think he hated spending any time there and would not find it worth writing about. Her story. Oh god, no. I don't want to make Harry a bad man. Whispers to the Ocean. Maybe it's just the For the Moon series in general, because it could be Longing for the Moon, it could be Crying for the Moon, it could be like a whole bunch of other verbs, you know? Oh, a collection of short stories. Short story anthology of some sort. Though there has to be a detective novel in there because he likes detective novels in Silent Hill 3. It's canon, okay? It's canon. Also, I should do a commercial break. Whoops! The werewolf fucker saga! Detective Brick Hoyt? Oh my god. Brick Hoyt? What kind of crazy ass name is that? I love it. But where'd you get that from? Is that real? Is that like from something? Oh man. Walls of Deception. That's a cool one too. Walls. I like these. All these fake things of deception. Oh man, some good shit. Okay, let's do the commercial thing. A Blaze Goes On It. There's gonna be Brick Hoyt fan art soon. I hope it's just a brick with a gun. A realistic brick with a gun and a fedora. That's it, Brick Hoyt. It's kind of like Chicken Boo. You wear a disguise to look like human guys, but you're not a man. You're Brick Hoyt! Everybody's like, wow, he's so stoic. He's so serious. And it's like, he's a brick! Does anyone else notice this guy's a brick with a hat on? Okay, let's color this ding-dang thing. But I wanted that to be white. I'm trying to remember what, like, the carpet and stuff looked like in their apartment. I don't remember. It was, like, green or something. I don't remember. Mean to make a group. Get out of here. Get out of here, you group. You're a loose cannon, Brick. I'm not another brick in the wall. Oh man. You're a loose brick, Brick. Oh my god. Sheesh. Sheesh. You guys are goofballs and I like it. Oh, this is really hard to say. Make the background something that's dark, so definitely see what colors I'm using here. Everyone's in love with the brick. The brick has a heart of stone. I want to build a life with you, Brick. Honey, I don't build anything but walls around my heart. A little too yellowy, it's kind of a weird skin tone there. Brick has a peppy sidekick. Everyone loves your original character entity. Is that an ugly line art that is astray? Get out of here. Get out of here, varmint. Throw me, kid. Anybody wants to make an indie game? Brick Hoyt might be a great character. Be kind of like a I Am Bread, but it's got a brick in it. The people love Brick Hoyt. Brick Hoyt is longing for the moon. You don't see these little tiny pixels of fuck-uppery until you start coloring. Fuck-uppery. Pebbles Corduroy. Little Johnny Alabaster. Pebbles Corduroy is really good, too. Man, oh man, you guys knocking it out of the park with the jokes today, I swear. Oh, Harry Mason, what color are your clothes? Yeah, he's got that, like, he's got the blue jeans. Right, right. Put that there. He's got, like, a dark blue sweater vest situation. Not dark blue enough. Darker blue. Yeah. He's got like a light blue. Man, he's so blue. Got a light blue undershirt sitch, which might be, it might be white actually. I don't really know. Kind of like a off gray. That is almost the exact same color. Then he's got the brown jacket. All right, cool. Get out of here. Yeah, it's like a vest. I didn't see what color his belt is, but I bet it's brown or black if I had to reckon a guess there. Minus needles. Make me laugh. Brooke Hoyt, Pebbles Corduroy. Yeah, maybe that'll be, someday I'll draw a cover for one of their exploits. Their detective exploits. Longing for the moon. That was big with moms. Popular with moms. Oh, that's right. Alaska, you scan things. You don't have a tablet, do you? Is that right? Am I remember that correctly? Am I remembering that correctly? Man, this is an ugly color with that purple behind it. Makes it look almost green, doesn't it? Color theory, y'all. Color theory. No tablet. Bet you'd do some cool things if you had a tablet, Ablisco. That'd be neat. It can be pricey, though. I understand that. The one I had before this one, which is Chips, was also a hand-me-down, I believe. And I had it for fucking 10 years or something. But it does not work with this PC. But this one does, and this is also like a 6-year-old tablet at least. They last for a pretty long time. Harry Mason. Just black belt having dude. His hair is darker than I made it. Okay. That looks better on him, doesn't it? Yeah, he's got like brass rivets on his jacket collar. I don't know why.
Oh man, looks good. Brick white.
Very angular. I like him. color was this couch? I think it was red. Wait, let me check that. Harry Mason SH3. Not couch, chair. Did I say couch? Ugh, there's a weird... Oh, I hate this. There's a weird... I don't know why I hate this, but there's a really weird... Oh, I know why I hate this. Okay. There is a weird picture of Harry Mason, and it's not the correct Harry Mason. It's Shattered Memories Harry Mason. And he's, like, holding hands with Heather, and she's wearing, like, a prom dress, and I hate this. Oh, man, can I just... Okay. I'm just gonna have to paste this in the chat because it's on DeviantArt, so it's not... It's not gonna show up, probably. Oh, it did! Wow. Yeah, I hate this. I hate this so much. Like, what is this? Like a prom photo or what? Or are they like... Oh, no. I don't know. I don't like it. Oh gosh, and somebody, oh that's sad, somebody also made like, they're trying to make Harry's texture look like he's alive, and he just, his skin is all like decaying looking still, and it's really spooky. I don't like this at all. Oh no, they have like sexy pictures of Heather and stuff. Posing with his daughter, good times before the tragedy. I'm like, what the hell? This is so strange. I don't get it. Anyway, what color is the fucking couch he dies on? Spoiler alert. Ew, it's ugly. It's an ugly couch color. Ugh. Yeah, I hate that. Yeah, it does look like Bella Goth's dress. You're so right. Alright, I'm just gonna like... make this kind of small and on the side so I can just see it. I'm not gonna like post it in there because it's just like, it's just an ugly ass corpse picture. I just care about the ugly ass couch, actually. Ew, it's so ugly. I thought it was red or something. Like, this is a really nasty color that they went for, this couch. I mean, it's very, very good, you know, modeling and pose work. I mean, don't want to make entire fun of this person. It's just kind of a creepy thing to do, in my opinion, but that's just me. Ugh. I might change the color of this couch because it's fucking ugly. So fucking ugly. Like, if I saw this couch on the side of the road, and it were free, and it were in perfectly good condition, I still would not take it. It's a very heinously ugly couch. Or whatever. Chair. Armchair. Well, I know there's sexy drawings of everybody, but I just thought it was weird because they had like... they were trying to have like make a tender scene between a father and daughter, like, aww. And then like the next one in their list was like Heather posing in a bikini, and I was like, Why has everybody gotta use their modeling skills for evil? Not evil, but you know what I mean. For creepy things. Ugh, god. It's ugly. Don't judge me. I'm not choosing this color. This is what's in the game. Ew, I hate it. I'm probably gonna end up changing it just because I hate it so much. I'm gonna make it red or something. Can I just make it red? I'm just gonna make it red. I hate it. I want it to be red. Be like a maroon. A maroon would be nice. Yeah, nicer looking couch. Sorry, armchair. It looks so comfy, I keep calling it a couch. It's like big and plush. Sorry, my elbow keeps dragging along and making that vroot noise. I'm denying the existence of this ugly couch, replacing it with my own less uglier couch. Gonna have to clean up Heather some more too. The line art is a little iffy in some places. Yeah, the official SH3 soundtrack cover. She's like, she doesn't have a shirt on underneath her vest, and it's like cleavage-y. It's like, what? Why? At no point in the game is she ever portrayed sexily. There's like the sexy beam costume, but that's a joke. Really weird. Really weird shit. There's their ugly, ugly apartment walls. I'm just not happy with her skin color for some reason. Doesn't look right. Whatever, I can always go back and change it again if it isn't working out. It could also be that like this purple background is throwing off the whole color process here, making everything look super weird. I should save that little image in a tab. Yeah. No, I don't think you dreamed that. That's also in Dance Dance Revolution, like Extreme 2 or something? Or Extreme. They always put some Yamaoka songs on there because, hell, they already have them. They're Konami. They also put, they made Cynthia from Silent Hill 4 sing and dance to the song You're Not Here or whatever. No, it wasn't. I forget what it's called. The one that's like, on the sidewalk in the city, are my screams just a whisper? Busy people going nowhere. No compassion, nothing matters. A ridiculous song. Oh no, her hair. I need it to be more yellow so I can see it better. Differentiate it from her skin tone. Sounds like Half-Life music, sort of. Don't ask me about Kingdom Hearts lore. I don't know fucking hardly anything about Kingdom Hearts. Played the first one. That's it. I don't even think I played the second one. And if I did, I don't remember even doing it, so. Kingdom Hearts is one huge confusing mess to me. I have no comment on it besides, holy shit, what? That's my comment. Holy shit, what? Alright. Get in here and fix a couple of little line art glitches. Chat's going fast about Kingdom Hearts lore. You're leaving me behind. This needs to be more of like a cherry, like a mahogany. One of those, like, you know, sexy dark woods. I love those dark woods. That's too bright. Harry's shoes, I keep forgetting. They're probably not the same as his feeties. That is, as his feeties are probably not the same color as his jacket. Monster kicking shoes. Yeah. Probably caked in blood on the bottom. Stretch. Figure out more about the coloring situation. Oh, what should the cover of Longing for the Moon look like? it's a romance novel, so it's probably gotta be like pink or red with like some darker colors for the passion, the mystery, the intrigue, the forbiddenness. Wine red, but that's already the color of that, of his, the thing he's sitting on. The chair. Mm-hmm. It's always a full moon, that's true. It could be like, you know, it could be a dark night. The moon is like reflecting off the surface of water or something. Be like, you know, a simple cover. One of those kind of like fancy. One of those things, you know. So it's easier to see. Like a drop shadow, it's white or something. Well, I like that too, actually. It does let it stand out. Just normal or something. Well, maybe. Nope, not that. Not color burn. I like lighten. Lighten's nice. It's fine. Longing for the moon gives you a lot of transphobic memes? What the hell? That's bizarre. Not know about that. Pretty unsavory. Oops. All right, we've got us some longing for the moon. Why is my cursor gigantic? You can't see it, but at least I don't think you can see it. It looks really big to me. I can't see it now. Okay. I like that a little better. What? That's ridiculous. Oh my god. Politics, am I right?
Why does my mouse cursor feel like it's fucking dopey and huge?
What happened? Aroused by two lions? What the fuck kind of title is that? I know it's not literal, I hope. Maybe they're like werewolves, but instead of wolves, they're lions. You know, like every full moon they turn to a lion. Is that a thing that people, that exists? Not a thing people can do, but is that a thing that exists? The genre of turning into other animals at moonlight. Are there like were-giraffes or anything? Yeah, that seems like a Chuck Tingle thing. Where was I gonna go? What was I gonna do? Close this window. Close that window too. Okay, we got some dope copy over. Got some textures for the background of their shitty house. Pounded in the butt by two transformed lions. Wow. What a genre. What a fucking genre. I kind of like imagine their house and from this angle, but it's not really really makes sense to me. There's like a hallway back here, and this would be like the breakfast nook, but like why would they be posing in front of that shit? Let's just pose them in front of like a plain ass fucking wall. Let's not get weird about this. Some color here. Ah, bothering me. Ugly, bad colors. Aw, that's cute. It's cute, Heather. Ugly house. I'm gonna give them a different rug because I don't know what the fuck to do with this nasty. The house is so gross. But you're a horse. What the fuck? He's got a horse head, but he's got man arms. He's like a reverse centaur. What the hell? What the hell? That is aggressively strange. Super horribly strange. Reinverts doing this silly. Easy way to pinstripe this? I don't even know, actually. I guess just... These are so weird, oh my god. Okay. Yep. Dang it, the tolerance is too high. Hand hit something weird. Sigh. Whoever's leaving, indestructible cat. Thanks for popping in. Man, some of these colors are just like being weird, driving me crazy. Probably going to be some, like, a molding at the bottom here, actually. Do 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 do. Ew, what the hell? The hungry ones. why is that clown so hungry? Backwards and dumb. I went in the wrong area. Um, There it is. Stroke.
Duh.
Duh. I keep hitting that for some reason. Silly. Hitting silly buttons.
Don't mind me.
Dinosaur forced me to be gay. Man, what a dicky dinosaur. What the hell's wrong with that guy? So what is that thing? That's on the line art layer. Weird. Get out of here. That's not the line art layer. Get out of here. Okay, the background's not very important. I might blur it a little. Blurring backgrounds always makes the background look better. It's lazy. Oh well. I gotta have better colors first before I blur the shit. These colors over here are just fucking ugly. It's just fact of fucking nature that these browns are hideous. What the hell? The tricycle and... Why is that skeleton boy on a tricycle? I've got lots of questions about the skeleton boy on the tricycle. Okay, that's a bit less ugly than what it was, because it used to be ugly like that. Mangasaurus Rex. This is gonna look weird for a second. Bear with me. I got kind of an idea. We'll just see how it works out. Why is this so tiny? What the hell? It's like 70. Bear with me, I'm just trying something a little weird. I don't know if it's gonna end up working out or not. Just curious. There. They're just sitting like normal people. Holy crap. It's hilarious. Why is this like so blue? It's really weird. Yeah, why is it blue? Whatever. It doesn't matter because we're changing it all anyway, so whatever. Where's desaturate? It's over here somewhere. This sounds like the song that happens in Yakuza 0 when you're doing the minigame for getting weapon stuff from across the world. It sounds a little like that. Now I could probably blur it and it won't look as much like shit. If I could find the dang blur filter. I'm just getting lost today in Photoshop for no reason. Too blurry. Too blurry. Shading stuff. Let's do that similar thing. That similar thing. Let's use black and then make it. Hey, I didn't mean to make you a group. Dang it. Let's make it black for now and then we will fix it. Why is it blue? What is happening with the blue? Why is it blue? What the hell? Color dynamics? Is that what it's doing? I guess it was color dynamics. That was fucking weird. Very strange indeed. Thank you. Brickiverse. Oh my god. Fucking Brickiverse. Bricky gender. Brick. Oh, man. I haven't done too much of this kind of shading. I feel like I should get back into it a little bit. Oh my god. It works. It all works. Thank you. mostly like where this is going right now. This is okay. Aww. Pebbles Corduroy. Plucky sidekick. I bet Pebbles Corduroy is like the tech side of things, you know, because he's the younger generation, so he'll be like the hacker or something. That's my idea. I do like that idea, Meteorga. It's funny. That's good. Some good shit. Run out of songs. Oh, I ran out of songs on the first page, I think. Did I? Well, I don't recognize this one, so whatever. Guys going to you guys running wild, this wiki idea. Thanks, Papa. Oh my god. Oh my god, you guys are really running with it. It's pretty great. What's that? What's that ugly bit there?
Well, it's part of the background now. Dang it.
Oh no, it's not part of the background. Okay. Where is it? Oh.
There you are. You tricky devil. I'm gonna color it all. Can't stop me. Can't stop a place, Co. Shading. She's not as angular as Harry, so she doesn't probably doesn't need that much shadow on her. This is a very elaborate inside joke. This brick stuff. God.
Been a week.
Brick hits criminals hard and fast. Oh my god. Who looks like his dead Ify? Oh my god, entity. I guess it's gonna be a thing. The thingening is happening. Very exciting.
meh. Oh my god, so goofy. You guys are a creative force to be reckoned with. Lego, no! Gotta put our roots in somewhere. Or... I feel like they gotta be different line quality. Back to the regular line quality. Like that. I'm being quiet. Concentrating. That looks better. Let's put our freckles on here too, why not? Being like really anal about the colors here, and I'm not even very good at colors at all. Ah, chicken pox. You're making a wiki? Are you really doing it? Oh my god. You guys. That's nuts. I love it. Ah. Oh my god. It beautiful. Man, people are gonna start watching the draw streams more often because there's like a lore behind them now a little bit. Oh man. It's great. Freaking, what else do I want to do here? Well, I want to give Heather her little, like, she has this, like, kind of pinkish complexion around her eyes. Let's see what we can do if... do some shading stuff. Was I supposed to run a commercial earlier? I feel like I was supposed to, and I didn't. Do you guys know if I did that? I feel like maybe I didn't run a commercial. Multiply. I only ran one. I was supposed to run another one. Oopsies. Oopsie doodles. Whoa. There's like a glowing relic off screen or something. That's what he sounds like.
Gee whiz, Pop, I can hack it. It's a Unix system. I know this.
You guys. Okay, I'm gonna do the commercial. I'm gonna do it. I don't mind the just black shading with a opacity on it. It's not horrible. Let's check out the other things we can do. See if it looks any different. Overlay might look good if we color, if we adjust it to be a color. Let's find out what happens. It just kind of gets lost on their skin then. Weird. Just gonna keep it normal and just lighten her up a little bit. Building behind the scenes. It's all this shit.
it's like a border around it or something. What's the town? The town is Portland. I believe that was where, if I'm not mistaken, there's only a few towns in the Silent Hill series that's mentioned. There's Silent Hill, of course. There's Portland, which is where Harry and Heather live. And if you go to like the subway, there's like, you know, like all the different subway stops for all the streets in Portland, stuff like that, like Bergen Street, which is from Jacob's Ladder. And then there's like South Ashfield, which is where Henry and all the jerks in Silent Hill 4 live, except for all the jerks that are in Silent Hill. But those are the three main towns that ever get mentioned. But Portland is where they moved to after the events of Silent Hill 1, but also after the events of, apparently Harry like killed a guy in self-defense because like a cult guy was trying to like hunt them down or something. Oh, you're talking about brick lore. I'm sorry, I got excited about the only lore I know about. I don't know about Calibri, it's a weird font. Helvetica's big, right? Are we like done with Helvetica? Oh, we can use the Silent Hill font, but that would be really stupid. She's a classy one like Baskerville. Yeah. I'm an important contributor to the Brickoverse. The fucking Brickoverse. Oh my god. So should the, this is, it's gonna be weird, but should this be the same color as the Longing for the Moon background? And then it's like, it's the back of the book. Whoa. It's like meta, you know, real meta. Okay, what if I take the same drop shadow, but alter it a little bit. So it's less, you know, ugly. Or maybe if it's black, it won't look so, oops, look so bad. No, it looks worse. I am no graphic designer, can you tell? I never know what the fuck I'm doing graphic design-wise. Yeah, a little bit of book section here. Yeah, let's mess with the drop shadow a little bit because it's a little overpowering. I just want like a hint. There, a little more of a hint. Okay, a Portland-based writer of romance and detective novels. He's a single father of a lovely 16-year-old. Pictured, right? How about a lovely young woman? Pictured, right? Outside or inside, I don't know. I've seen it both. Also known for Whispers to the Ocean, Bridge Over the Sorrow, Walls of Deception, and the Detective Brick Hoyt series. Oh my god. I don't think I need to be a mod on the Brickiverse wiki. I feel like this is your own thing and I just like incepted it, but I feel like it's separate. You know? I want to see where Brickiverse goes without much input from me. I guess. He's killed a man in self-defense and is in witness protection program or something, so please don't tell any cult members that you read here. these might go within the quotes. Well, there has to be some, there's gotta be mild overlap of the Brickoverse, because Harry Mason wrote it, right? Oh man. Longing for the moon. I wanna see the liner over here. I wanna see what might happen if I add some sort of, I want like some sort of gradient layer to kind of make, I don't know, make this blend a little better, because there's a lot of like kind of warm colors here and then a lot of like cool colors, so it's a little clashy. So I want to see if I can do a little something like this. Then I gotta go to the drop shadow stuff. Steal that color. Which you can't see happening because for some reason it doesn't capture these things. To be something that makes sense here. Longing for a gradient. Hoping there's going to be one that makes some sense. Blech, it's got ugly. That it gets like weird halfway up, like it's just right here. This makes it look more like a photo at least. Not feeling it. Nah. I don't think it's gonna work out. There's a potential to work out though. I want it to work. Maybe it's because it's over the line art, it's looking weird. Nope, still looks weird. Nah. Get deleted. Get out of here. You fool. Manually drag you to be deleted. Maybe this is done. Maybe this is, I don't know, is there something else I should do here? The background's boring, but I'm not feeling it. I don't feel like we need to get obsessed with the background. I don't like doing backgrounds. Ugly stuff down here. Get out of here. You're not allowed. Hmm.
Can't see that shit. Can't see that shit neither. Cool beans. Maybe we're done. Oh, I gotta stretch. Oh my goodness. Blech. Well, congratulations on everyone's new son, Brick Hoyt. Brick motherfucking Hoyt. I could do a button stream. I was thinking though of using like the examples that I showed for printoutable buttons when I switched the Patreon over to not be constantly hand drawing buttons all the time. It takes forever. And ones that I could just print out. I used an example of two buttons I did a test for, and it was kind of like a Sonic and a Tails, and Sonic was like a realistic blue hedgehog, and he was on like a skateboard, a real looking skateboard, and I think like it doesn't really look like a fox, it looks more like a corgi, but it was supposed to be Tails initially, but he's like surfing on some waves. I'm gonna ask Patreon if they are okay with me just using those, because when they saw those, they were like, oh, those are so cute! So I think they might just want to have those anyway, so it's like, why not just give them those ones that I already designed, you know? So, I don't know. I also don't know if Brick Hoyt's gonna, like, catch on. You know, the Drawstream crowd is a little bit of a different crowd from, the LP crowd, also, and also the stream, regular video game streams crowd, so, Brick Hoyt could happen, I don't know. But if I don't have to do additional work, because I already did that cute, like, Tails dog surfing and cute realistic Sonic skateboarding, then it's like, you know, it's already made, so... I don't know. But yeah, I guess I'm done. I need to do... You know, speaking of Silent Hill 3, I need to record some more Silent Hill 3. I'm finally actually recording it. It took a long time to get things right. It's kind of... I don't know, Konami did not port their games good. So, it's a lot of bullshit to get working right. But yeah, it looks good so far, so yay for recording, yay! So I'll see you guys tomorrow, well, for Stardew's Day, you know, quotation fingers Stardew's Day. But I think I'm gonna try to play the Turing test again. I'm gonna see if there's like some sort of FOV slider in there so I don't get hyper nauseous again. So yeah, see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching and goofing off with me and adding to the Brick Hoyt lore. You guys are pretty great. Thanks a lot. See you. See ya. Bye.